إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستغفره ونستعينه ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أرسله بالحق بشيرا ونذيرا بين يدي الساعة، صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. أما بعد، عباد الله، أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله. قال تبارك وتعالى: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. عباد الله، أكرم الله تعالى نبيه صلى الله عليه وسلم بفضائل جمة وصفات عدة، فأحسن خلقه وأتم خلقه حتى وصفه تعالى بقوله: وإنك لعلى خلق عظيم. ومنحه جل جلاله فضائل عديدة وخصائص كثيرة تميز بها صلى الله عليه وسلم عن غيره، فضلا عن مكانة النبوة التي هي أشرف المراتب. ومن أخلاقه عليه الصلاة والسلام هذه القصة الغريبة العجيبة، عندما جاءت امرأة إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ببردة، أي كساء مخطط يلتحف به، يعني مثل لحفة، فقالت: يا رسول الله، أكسوك هذه. فأخذها النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم محتاجا إليها، أخذها النبي وهو محتاج لهذه الكسوة، فلبسها، دخل بيته ثم لبس الكسوة وخرج بها، فرآها عليه رجل من الصحابة فقال: يا رسول الله، ما أحسن هذه، فاكسنيها. فنظر إليه فقال: نعم. فلما قام النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لامه أصحابه، قالوا لهذا الرجل: ما أحسنت حين رأيت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أخذها محتاجا إليها ثم سألته إياها وقد عرفت أنه لا يسأل شيء فيمنعه. فقال الصحابي: رجوت بركتها حين لبسها النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لعلي مكفن فيها. صحيح البخاري. وروى البخاري أيضا من حديث أنس بن مالك أنه قال في صفة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: كان أحسن الناس خلقا وخلقا عليه الصلاة والسلام. My respected brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam the most beautiful of physical attributes and the most beautiful of character. Aside from the fact that he was given the privilege of being the last and the final of prophets and messengers, he was adorned and beautified with the most excellent of character. And we as his followers are meant to follow his footsteps sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And what I want to do today is share with you just a small sample of some of the stories that demonstrate his sublime character sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In this beautiful narration, a woman, a sahabiya, a noble companion, female companion of the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, came to him and she gave him the type of a blanket that was decorated slightly. And she said, "O Messenger of Allah, I made this specially for you. Please accept it." And the hadiyah, he accepted the gift, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but not the sadaqah. Because he's a Nabi, and he and the family of Rasulullah sallam do not accept sadaqah, but he accepted hadiyah. He said, "Tahabu, give gifts to each other, and Allah will create love between your hearts." Now the narrator says, Rasulullah accepted it and he was in need of it. He needed it. This is Rasulullah. This is amazing. I mean, if he wanted, he could have been a king. He needed that. So he went inside, put it on himself, and then he came out. One of the men who was sitting, he looked looked at it and he said, "Oh, Messenger of Allah, it is so beautiful. Can I have it?" And Rasulullah never said no to anybody who asked for anything halal. Never. So he went inside again, took it off, and gave it to him. The men who were sitting there said to that Sahabi, they said, "How could you do that? How could you ask when you knew, you saw that Rasulullah needed it, but you took it from him, and you know that he doesn't say no to anyone?" He said, "Wallahi, I know that. But I took it because the minute he put it on his body, it became blessed, Mubarak. And I wanted to put that Mubarak cloth on my body, and I hope that I will be wrapped with it when I die." I mean, the amazing thing, of course, about this is the akhlaq, the character of Rasulullah. One, he didn't say no, though he needed it. He did not say no. He needed it, alayhi salam, but that was his character, alayhi salam. That is why Bukhari says that Anas radiallahu anhu tells us about him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, كان أحسن الناس خلقا خلقا وخلقا. Rasulullah was the best of people in his appearance, in his physical form, and in his character. فلهذا إخوة الله من أراد أن يعرف خلق رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فليقرأ وليتدبر القرآن وليفهم فكل خصلة خير أمر الله في القرآن بالتخلق بها فهي من خلق رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. And so therefore, if you truly want, if we truly want to follow the blessed steps of Rasulullah ﷺ, then read and understand the Quran. And you will find that every beautiful and noble quality that Allah speaks about in the Quran is present in Rasulullah ﷺ. وأخرج أبو بكر في كتابه مكارم الأخلاق أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال: كنت بين شر جارين. يعني هو ساكن وفي هذا الجنب جار شرير وفي هذا الجنب جار شرير. جارين عطلة لأبي معيط وأبي لهب كانا يرميان بما يخرج من الناس علي وعلى بابي وما كان يقول شيء عليه الصلاة والسلام. It is narrated, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, "I was living in between the two worst neighbors." The two neighbors were very evil. And what they used to do is they used to take the waste and the filth that people throw in the bins and throw it in front of the door of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. فَكَانَ يَتَحَمَّلْ هَذَا الْأَذَى. And he used to forbear. He never responded. He never avenged for himself, as Aisha radiallahu anha said. Nowadays, you know, the Arabs say, you go and look for a house, اختار الجار قبل الجار, الدار. You should choose the neighbor before you choose the house. Because the neighbor can make your life good or miserable. In this case, Rasulullah is living between two neighbors who were, one is Uqba bin Abi Mu'ayyid and Abu Lahab. And they used to do harm to him, alayhi salam. أي أنه صلى الله عليه وسلم كان يتحمل أذاهما مع أنه كان أشجع خلق الله على الإطلاق. وقد أوتي من القوة البدنية قوة 40 رجلا. ومع ذلك كان العفو خلقه والصبر شيمته وتحمل الأذى من الغير حاله ودابه. Despite the fact that Rasulullah was a very strong man, don't think that by him being quiet and silent and not responding is that because of his weakness. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was the bravest of all men. And Ali radiallahu anhu, Ali, the brave warrior, the lion, he used to say, إِذَا حَمِيَ الْوَقِيسِ كُنَّا نَخْتَرِقْ وَرَاءَ النَّبِي sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, when the going got tough in the battlefield, we hid behind him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was given the strength of 40 men. Yet, he was patient, and he was forbearing, and he was forgiving, alayhi salatu wasalam. وعن أنس قال: كنت أمشي مع رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم، وعليه برد نجراني غليظ الحاشية، فأدركه أعرابي، جاءه أعرابي، كان لابس النبي. نفسه وجهل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. ثم نظرت، أن يقول الراوي، نظرت إلى صفحة عاتق النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قد أثرت بها هذه الجذبة، يعني عثرت على رقبته صلى الله عليه وسلم. ثم قال مع هذا العربي، مع أنه سحب النبي بقوة، يقول للنبي عليه الصلاة والسلام: يا محمد مر لي من مال الله، أعطني المال الذي عندك. فالتفت إليه رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ثم ضحك ثم أمر له بالعطاء. لا إله إلا الله. أنس رضي الله عنه سئل: I was walking with رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. What an honor to be walking with رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. May Allah تعالى give us the tawfiq to see him on the day of Qiyamah and to drink from his hands inshaAllah. He said, I was walking with Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم and he was wearing a Yemeni jubba that was of harsh material, coarse material. And as we were walking suddenly, and I want you to imagine yourself in this situation. You are walking and a man comes from behind, grabs you from the back of the collar and pulls you so hard that it marks your neck. That's what he did to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. He pulled him so hard that it marked the Prophet's neck. And not only this, then he shouted at him and he said, oh Muhammad, give me some of the money that Allah gave me. Now if it was you or it was me, we know what we do. You're walking and somebody comes and slaps you on your back. You don't turn around and smile, especially if you're strong. But he, alayhi salatu wasalam, turned around with a smile. And he said, give him. That's it. Give him. This is our Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We don't talk about these stories so that we can, they're not fairy tales. This is to emulate him alayhi salatu wasalam. وَلِهَذَا قَالَ الْحَبِيبُ الْمُصْطَفَى صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ مَا شَيْءٌ أَثْقَلُ فِي مِيزَانِ الْمُؤْمِنِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ مِنْ مَالِهِ لا مِنْ خُلُقٍ حَسَنٍ فإن الله تعالى لا يبغض الفاحش البذيء. حديث رواه الترمذي وهو حسن صحيح. And that is why رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, he walked the talk, he practiced what he preached. He said صلى الله عليه وسلم, there is nothing heavier. Listen to this carefully. On the day of judgment, our deeds do not get counted. It's not by quantity. Allah doesn't say you have a million deeds. They are weighed. The deeds are weighed. That's why he says half a day in sadaqah. Nus tamra. If the sadaqah is an ikhlas, tunjih min al-nar. Na'am, la'na tuzan halil a'mal. Nabi sallallahu says half a day, given in sadaqah. But with pure ikhlas can save a man or a woman from jahannam on the day of judgment. Because when Allah weighs that half a day, it will tip the scale. So Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, on the day of judgment, there will be nothing heavier in the scale of a believing man or woman than his good character and conduct. Meaning what? Meaning this should be the focus. People have New Year resolutions, I want to do this and I want to do that. Excellent. How about a New Year resolution? I want to improve my character. I want to be like him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. ولهذا إخوة بالله سكر ربه في عقله صلى الله عليه وسلم فقال عنه ما ضل صاحبكم وما غوى وزكاه في بصره فقال ما زاد البصر وما طغى وزكاه في صدره أو صدره قال ألم يشرح لك صدرك وزكاه في ذكره قال ورفعنا لك ذكرك وزكاه في ظهره قال ووضعنا عنك وزرك وزكاه في صدقه قال وما ينطق عن الهوى وزكاه في علمه قال علمه شديد القوى وزكاه في حلمه قال للمؤمنين رؤوف رحيم وزكاه في خلقه كان كله كما قال تبارك وتعالى وإنك لعلى خلق عظيم صلى الله عليه وسلم. And that is why Allah made him perfect. There can be no perfect human being except him صلى الله عليه وسلم and the prophets. Zero. Nobody can ever claim to be perfect. And that's why Allah Ta'ala, to perfect him, Allah Ta'ala purified his intellect. He made his intellect perfect. That's why Allah Ta'ala says about him, ما ضل صاحبكم own حق. And Allah Ta'ala purified his heart for him. أَلَمْ نَشْرَحْ لَكَ صَدْرَكَ. Allah says, have we not opened your bosom and chest and cleaned it for you? And Allah Ta'ala purified his remembrance in his name. وَرَفَعْنَا لَكَ ذِكْرَكَ. And we elevated your status and name. And Allah Ta'ala purified him in his body. وَوَضَعْنَا عَنْكَ وِزْرَكَ. Allah says, have we not raised and lifted the burden of you, O Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. And so on. فحسن الخلق إخوتي في الإسلام عبارة عن تحمل أذى الغير وكف الأذى عن الغير وبذل المعروف ببساطة ولكنها صعبة. نبي that's why the حسن الخلق the ulama define حسن الخلق excellent character in the following way. It's a simple definition but it is not very easy to acquire. They said تحمل أذى الغير. You must be patient when others harm you. Try to be forbearing. Try to be patient. وَكَفِّ الْأَذَى عَنْ غَيْرِ. And don't harm others. If others harm you, try to be patient. And you mention you don't harm others. We don't harm them with our tongue. And that's why the ulama say it is haram to harm people physically, psychologically, mentally, or financially. Including your wife at home, and your husband at home, and the children. And also to do good. That is what حسن الخلق. وأخيرا فقط قصة أخرى عنه عليه الصلاة والسلام عن جابر أخبر أنه غزا مع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قبل نجد خرجوا في غزوة فلما قفل رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يعني جاء يرتاح تحت الشجرة قفل معه الناس فأدركتهم القائلة في واد كثير العظام فنزل رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وتفرق الناس يستظلون حرب في بعض الشجر كل واحد أخذ ظل شجرة واستظل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم تحت شجرة فنزل رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم تحت سمرة وعلق بها سيفه علق السيف قال ونمنا نوما فإذا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يدعونا وإذا عنده أعرابي فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول إن هذا الأعرابي اختلط علي سيفي يعني أخذ السيف من الشجرة اللي كان علقها على الشجرة قال وأنا نائم أخذ السيف وأنا نائم فاستيقظت وهو في يده صلتا يعني استيقظ النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وهذا الأعرابي يده السيف على رقبة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فقال الأعرابي للرسول طب ونائم النبي مستلقي عليه الصلاة والسلام وهذا الأعرابي يده السيف يعني تخيل أنت رجل معه مسدس وضعه على رأسه والآن يقول لك كما قال للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال من يمنعك يقول للرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم من يمنعك مني فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ثلاث مرات الله 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 فارتجفت يد الرجل وسقط السيف فتناوله النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ثم قال له من يمنعك مني قال انت كريم من كريم فلم يعاقبه وجلس الله كتلي Sahabi says we went out with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in an expedition in a battle, and on the way we all got tired. It was a very hot day, so we wanted to have a nap. And we came to a place that had some trees, and so everybody scattered to find a shade under the tree. And he sallallahu alaihi wasallam lied down and sat under one of those trees and hung his sword on the branch. As they were all sleeping, an A'rabi, a Bedouin who wasn't a Muslim, he came, but he recognized this is Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. Everybody's looking for him. I found him sleeping. He grabbed the sword of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, placed it on the neck of the Prophet, woke him up with his foot, and then he said to Muhammad, in that instant, صلى الله عليه وسلم, imagine yourself lying down and somebody, you know, a gun in your head, and the A'rabi says to him, who will save you from me now? He's saying to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in that very vulnerable state, who will save you from me now? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whose heart is connected with Allah directly, he looks at the man and he says to him, Allah, Allah, Allah is him. The man's hand shook, the sword fell, Rasulullah grabbed it, and now he put it on his neck, and he said, who will save you from me now? He said, you are a generous man, the son of a generous man, let him go. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم did not harm him.
He didn't say anything.
I mean, I can't believe it. It's so mind-boggling. The man was trying to kill the Prophet and intimidate him when he was in a vulnerable state. You know, you and I would destroy the world if that was the case. He صلى الله عليه وسلم lets him go. And in another riwayah, when the man went back to his tribe, قال لقد جئتكم من عندي خير الناس. He said, I have come to you from the best of people. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم يا فوز المستغفرين استغفروه إنه غفور رحيم. الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. وعن أنس بن مالك رضي الله عنه قال كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أحسن الناس وأجود الناس وأشجع الناس ولقد فزع أهل المدينة ذات ليلة خاف سمعوا صوت أهل المدينة فخاف فانطلق الناس قبل الصوت الكل فزع راح شافوا في صوت عالي في المدينة فوجدوني قبلهم فاستقبلهم النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قد سبق الناس إلى الصوت وهو يقول لن تراعوا لن تراعوا يعني هدوا ما تخافوا وهو جالس على فرس لأبي طلحة عري معني سر يعني حتى ما حد سرج على الفرس ركب الفرس وأخذ السيف وأخذ الجميع عليه الصلاة والسلام فقال لقد وجدته بحرا أو إنه لبحر قال النووي في هذا كله بيان عظيم عن سخائه صلى الله عليه وسلم وشجاعته وجوده عليه الصلاة والسلام Finally, Anas bin Malik says, one night in Medina, we heard a very loud voice sound that was terrifying, was scary. So everybody got up to go and they went towards the sound. And lo and behold, who did they find who was there first? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was there first and he was saying to them, take it easy, don't be frightened. And he was on a horse that wasn't, that he had borrowed. He didn't even have a saddle on it. He didn't wait to put the saddle on the horse and get ready. He rode the horse, took his sword, and went there before anybody else. And when they came to him, he said, it's all right. Nothing to worry about. The point is, he was there for the people. He was the bravest, he was the most generous, and he was the most kind, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he is our role model. He is humanity's uswa. He is the uswa for the whole world, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But let you and me, let us show that uswa. Let us live it so when people look at us, they say, Alhamdulillah for Islam. That is why, inshallah, every night after Maghrib, every Friday night after Maghrib, we have a seerah program. So please don't forget after Maghrib to write the seerah of Rasulullah sallam. هذا وصلوا وسلموا على رسول الله اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد يا أرحم الراحمين يا أرحم الراحمين يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم إنا نسألك من الخير كله عاجله وآجله ما علمنا منه وما لم نعلم ونعوذ بك من الشر كله عاجله وآجله ما علمنا منه وما لم نعلم اللهم إنا نسألك الجنة وما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل ونعوذ بك من النار وما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل اللهم إنا نسألك الخير ما سألك منه عبدك ونبيك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ونعوذ بك من شر ما استعاذك منه عبدك ونبيك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم اللهم ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا وللمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وصل اللهم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه الأخيار سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين
الله أكبر الله أكبر